Oh, there's a... Oh, wow. Oops. Ouchie. Mm. A cube. Hello? Hey, Joey. It's Joey, right? Yeah, that's right, and you're Xerox. No, actually, I'm Xefros. Oops. Are you okay? What's going on? I thought we weren't supposed to talk? Yeah, something weird happened, though. I think it's safe now. What do you mean? Real quick. Do you have a green and white symbol on your chat window now? Yeah, the lock? Oh, hey, yeah, that wasn't there before. Okay, I think we're safe then. The chat, anyway. Okay, good. I still don't quite get what the danger is, but... I guess I'm going to need to trust you if I have any hope of getting out of here. Well, some bad news on that front. A missile hit my hive and I'm buried under the debris in the lawn ring. A missile? I heard a big heavy thump a minute ago. Is that related? Yeah, that was probably the missile that nearly killed me. You need help way more than I do right now. I don't want to be a bother, but I was about to say something to those effects. Or, I mean, I was going to say I'm sorry I can't help you anymore, and we're both stuck waiting to find out if the flames or the drones will reach us first. Nuts to that. X, I'm going to save you. Aren't you stuck? I was, but that missile knocked some boxes over that I don't think I could have moved on my own, so in a weird way it kind of helped. Boxes? Yeah, they were blocking a vent shaft. I'm going to climb up there and see where it leads. Wow, you're... kind of like a real-life action hero? Wow. Oh, shucks. I want to help you the way you were going to help me. And you were putting yourself at a lot more risk than I realized. I repeat. X. XO, I've been meaning to ask... What the heck does that mean? Oh, you can use letters and numbers to make a little face. Tetrarch Dammek told me he likes it when I smile. We don't have theirs where I come from, but I don't know what the X means. Oh, those are my horns. Your horns? Yeah? Like the guy on this screensaver? I think so? It's probably not me, though. But those are real? Do you not have horns? I thought they were out of frame. No, I don't have horns. Jeez. What a question. That's so weird. And cool. You really are an alien. I never thought I'd meet one. Well, today's your lucky day. Or, I mean, it really seems to not be that, but you understand what I'm going for here. I think so, yeah. I'll be there as quick as I can, apply pressure to the wounds, and try not to move so much. Too much. It's okay. The weight of the rubble crushing my body is pressing down on my wounds and preventing me from moving at all. Man, Xerox. Buddy. We're really going to work on your concept of what's okay. Are those the missiles that fell, or were these already here? Okay, never looked over here. This seems to be a map, but you don't recognize the shapes of any of the landmasses depicted on it. Or, well, actually, now that you think about it, they maybe do look kind of familiar, but you're not sure where you would have seen them before. And we have this thing. You started calling this bizarre energy cube a power cell after deciding the word battery wasn't nearly cool enough. You don't really know what this is all about. You would kind of like to never find out, please? Shooting a monster. Detaching its head? Check. Alright, so I wanna... If I find that thing, I wanna shoot it in the head. With something. Okay. Okay. Use stuff with stuff. You don't see any place to put this weird glowing cube, which is just fine since you don't want that door to open up anyway. This sketchy diagram and this weird high-tech map clearly have nothing to do with one another. You're pretty much certain of it. Wow, is this how Buyer sees the world? From high overhead, his powerful brain calcula. You couldn't keep that up any longer. What a strange, unfamiliar landscape. You wonder if the spice trade ever gripped this world in its flavorful maw the way it did yours. You only wonder it for like a second, though. You've sort of got a lot on your mind at the moment. No batteries needed. This thing must have kicked back into gear when you got the power back on. The red dots kind of look like pogs? Well, not really. Man, what if each of these red dots represented a friendly pet who needed a nice treat? A cute idea, but also alarming, because who is going to give those friendly pets the nice treats they so desperately need? It would seem you have your mission. So we can identify a little bit more with Joey. The screen looks pretty heavy and very expensive. Tap dancing it loose would be very hazardous to your health, both physically and financially. Maybe the red dots are all cultural hubs where you will kill what you will one day perform your ballet for a crowd of admiring aliens. Or maybe not. Sometimes you're just throwing spaghetti at the wall and seeing what sticks. You hope this weird little cube isn't all full of all that twisty business? All that twisty business up there on the screen in the thing. You actually do notice some weird aesthetic similarities with what with the twisting, coiling stuff combined with the shiny plate stuff. You don't linger over these comparisons or anything, but you do notice them. You don't want to show that thing to buyers. You'd rather not deal with his fluttery terror poops right now. Gross. None of that looks like anything you want to eat. It doesn't look like anything that anyone should eat, ever. The big monitor doesn't seem to need power, and the weird thing on the monitor, it seems to be doing just fine, too. Whatever that thing is, you sincerely doubt it has a fatal pog allergy. You alone walk that path, it seems. Should that thing cross your path, you don't think you'll try feeding it. And send this heavy horror festoon monitor tumbling towards you? No thanks. If you ever come across this thing, well, let's just hope you have a chance to get warmed up first. Alright, stuff. Door. This huge monitor seems to be all set for weird energy, which is what this cube positively radiates. Hopefully not literally, but almost certainly literally. Oh. This reminds you of Jude's dorky conspiracy theories. Although you guess maybe they weren't actually conspiracy theories, more like conspiracy facts, apparently. You guess the same must go for all this stuff, but geez, do these dorks have to always dig themselves into such a crazy bones hole with the layered scrawls and everything? Same with everything? Okay. You go out that way. You really don't know what any of this stuff is, but it all makes you extremely uncomfortable. Like the tablet, you seem to be able to read the text, but you kind of rather not. That goes out. Okay, the only thing I want to do is try stuff on stuff like this. Well, just the cube, really. The sketchy diagram, well, hey, it actually does seem to have some kind of power source. You guess. You're not 100% on this. It's a sketchy diagram in an alien language of a double crocodile teleporter. You're not exactly an expert. Byers, you silly little angel, you can't run on alien power. You sprinkle just a little bit of pinch of spice onto the power cell. It vaporizes immediately. You think you should probably find a place to put this pretty quick, instead of just holding it in your bare hands all night. The two seem to be based on entirely different technology. For instance, the alien one is glowing. Wild. With utmost gravitas, you carefully place a pog directly on the middle of the power cell. Nothing happens. This would be a good solution to some kind of problem that necessitated an animal eating this power cell. You don't have one of those problems, though, so it's kind of a crappy solution. Don't step on this thing. It looks important. Also, it might kill you if you do that. Maybe it even lives here? You don't know a dang thing about this place. That's true. You admire this small device's ability to house such power and potential. It reminds you of yourself. Okay. Trying to get rid of the thing, okay. Oh, it's getting him out. I didn't have her leave yet, though. Is it really getting him out, or is it just gonna take forever? You've been pinned by the ruins of your destroyed gander precipice. You think. You can't really see all that well at the moment. Luckily, it seems your body shielded your tablet from most of the rubble. Hooray! Ow! Ah! Ouch! Ouch! You try, but it's too heavy. Zeus Smell is working on it, but at the rate he's going, it might be old age that does you in. Can't use stuff. You try removing the rocks with the power of your mind, but your mind is not very powerful. Okay. Your entire body hurts a lot. You think you'll not do anything that involves moving for a bit. Alright. Switching back. Thank you. Let us exit. A vent shaft was revealed when that missile strike knocked over some boxes. You could possibly fit inside, but if you had to? We have to. Watch out for those wires. Or cables. Extra thick wires. Great, a whole place to look around. Hey, I made it through the vent shaft. Wow. That's pretty exceptional. Well, gosh, thank you. It was a little creepy and, in retrospect, fairly dangerous. Or shall I say it was more dangerous than I expected? Well, I would rather you didn't, honestly. Oh, I'm sorry. No, it's okay, but typing quirks are sort of... I've noticed you don't really have one, but, they're kind of a thing that's exclusive to you, you know? Or, I mean, it's okay if they're used occasionally by someone you're close to. No offense, but I don't know you that well yet. Oh, I see. Well, I am sorry. I will know better from now on. No, I'm probably being weird about it. I'm sorry. You had no way of knowing. Xefros... Oh, she called him by his actual name. It says Xerox. It's okay to tell people when they do something that bothers you. Better express how you feel than sit on it forever while the other person has no idea. What kind of foundation for a friendship would that be? Oh. Yeah, you're right. By the way, how much rubble are you covered in exactly? I'm not really sure how I'm going to get you out of there. Well, that wouldn't be too hard if you can find my hover pad. It's around there somewhere. I use it to move my Lucis around, but Tetrarch Dammek borrowed it. Or to move some guns, I think, or maybe his drums. Oh, bad timing, haha. Well, I mean that was a couple sweeps ago. So I guess it's pretty much his now. You know what they say, your hive is my hive, hehe. Actually, that's mostly what the Tetrarch says is he's taking my stuff. Okay, that's nice, but where's the hover pad exactly? Oh, right, sorry. It's fine, I just don't want you to bleed to death or whatever while typing. I think it's probably still in the Tetrarch's loft above his respite block. Do you know where you are now? Not really, but... It's kind of dark and creepy. I don't want to make you anxious, but... That describes, every block in the Tetrarch's hive. Great. I'll message you when I've made some more progress, I suppose. Okay, yeah. I think I'm about to pass out from blood loss, so I'm gonna chill out for a little while. Hang in there. I'll find that hover pad soon. Okay. How much stuff? Why? This looks like some kind of safe, you guess? Hard to be sure, given your current surroundings, but it seems to fit the usual profile. Dammek seemed pretty paranoid. Even if you could crack this safe, it probably wouldn't be him safe to do so. Just a typical air vent, previously repurposed as a human vent, but it mostly deals in air. It does look like it fit pretty nice, but then again, this Dammek seems like a little paranoid and extremely dangerous. You don't know if you should be cracking a safe. Succeeding might be dangerous to your health. You scour the sketchy diagram for a safe combination. No dice. Byers is entirely incapable of picking the lock on a weird-looking alien safe. You assume maybe you should have more faith in the little guy. You can't spell saffron without safe. Yeah, you can. There's no E. That's pretty much all you got for this obscure item combination. You don't really expect it to open the safe, so you're not too disappointed by the underwhelming comedic payoff of your completionism. Wouldn't powering up the safe make it harder to open? This high-tech safe is absent a low-tech POG slot, which, wow, way to invent the wheel, Dammek. You waft some pet treats at the safe in an adorably naive attempt to get it to yield up its treasures. The safe is not your pet, nor is it alive. It is unswayed. It didn't move an inch. Man, Dammek must have really shelled out for such a secure safe, or built it himself, or maybe it birthed him. It's an alien planet. You don't know how any of this works, really. It's no use. Either the safe is specifically designed to be ballet-proof, or that's not a thing safes have specifically designed to be. You think you should maybe hold on to this thing, or at the very least not drop it down a vent shaft. The weird metal snakes on the sketchy diagrams kind of remind you of the vent shaft. Sorta. You put Byers in the vent. After a little while he returns with a new emptiness in his eyes. Time on the inside changed him. You realize this pigeon is now the toughest son of a bitch you've ever heard of. The rest of your adventure will be effortless child's play as your enemies are driven screaming before his fiery pinions falling like shell casings, a feathery staccato, the only elegy for the end of the world. The end of all worlds. That was awesome. You sprinkle some spice mix into the vent shaft, and it is predictably blown right back in your face. You are lost in the allspice haze for seconds, minutes, years, none can say. The vent doesn't seem to need batteries, you guess. You didn't really try very hard. You hurl a pog down the shaft. Good riddance. As far as you can tell, the vent shaft is not a pet. It is not, in your estimation, actually alive, but you're not 100% sure, so you give it a pet treat. It's really echoing in there. With acoustics like that, you could end up deafening yourself with your own feet. There's just not any room to maneuver in there. Okay, what's this? This is a Judge Dredd. The beautiful deer cat looks like a deer cat, but, are they common here or something? Okay, just look at that. Nothing works here, no. Back out. There's stuff out there. Hey, you can see the portal from here, right through this giant hole you made when you inadvertently laser-beamed yourself into Dammek's home. You hope you're not responsible for any of this damage. Nothing works. I don't mind very much. Looks like some kind of weird book. Maybe try picking the book up first instead of just jabbing weird cubes at it? That's not a sentence you'd ever thought you'd have to think to yourself, but here you are. It's a brave new world. More guns? Shouldn't want to use those. Still works? Only with that. Okay. Funny, it only works with that. Okay. Pick up. You pick up the... Let's say, it looks like this is a big book of beasts. You flip through, glimpsing tons of monsters at various levels of weird, cute, scary, and spectacular. You can use this to learn more about this weird planet... alien life on this weird alien planet. Neat! You can read this book just fine, thanks. The power cell is entirely superfluous to this particular task. Oof, yeah, lots of snaky looking things in here. No thanks. You don't find anything about Byers in here because he's just a little earth pidge. It's the big book of beasts, not the cookbook of feasts. No, it's just a regular book as far as you can tell. I'm loving the short passages here. Oh well. Wow, look at all these animals. You want to give every single one of them a treat. Even the horrifying ones. And wow, are there some horrifying ones. Nothing in here about any tap dancing beasts, although those giant spiders would probably be decent at it. Or terrible. Hard to say. Careful study of this tome will help you know when to leap the heck out of the way when one of these nightmare creatures comes lumbering at you. You pick a page at random and accidentally spend a few minutes reading about muscle beast pectoral tumescence. Maybe you should just use this on lucises that you actually encounter. Also hope that you never encounter that one. You pick a page at random and accidentally spend a few okay, never mind. Huh, the handprint is probably how this door is opened? Or maybe it just means that the room on the other side is room 4 or room hand. Maybe that's just the obvious local sign for lethal monsters, do not enter? Either way, this thing doesn't seem to be powered. No dice. You guess it's out of power, maybe? Okay. Is that when I look at this? Oh. What's it say? Cool. I think I read that, maybe? The cube will work with it? Oh, cool. I'm not done in here yet. Hey! I'm not done in there. Hey! Hi, Joey. How's it going? Not great. I accidentally put everything in lockdown. Or maybe it was in lockdown before and I somehow got past one door? That's probably it. The Tetrarch has an extremely high security. What's the deal? Is he really paranoid or is your planet really dangerous? It must be if everyone's house is full of guns. Actually, my hive is pretty different. It is a lot cleaner, for one thing. And there's a tree growing in it for my lucis. And there's no guns. That sounds really nice. What does he even need so many guns for, anyway? Well, I guess it's okay to tell you since you're another rust blood. But don't tell anyone else, it's a major secret. I don't know a single other person on your entire planet. Oh, right. Okay, but, yeah. So... we're rebelling. Huh? It's okay, you can take a minute. I know it's a lot to process. Rebelling against what? The man? No, the heiress is a girl. Right, you're an alien, okay? Some context. The heiress is a murdering tyrant who holds our entire planet in her wicked finny fist. Finny? Yes, she's a sea dweller, and a fuchsia blood. One of the only two. The other one, well, she's really far away all the time, leading the conquest of other galaxies or whatever. Which is lucky for us, because she's incredibly powerful. Not so lucky for the other people in the other galaxies, though. Huh? Oh yeah, that's true. But anyway, the heiress is enough to deal with. The other high bloods follow her, and of course she has her drone army. Well, of course, ain't that always just the way? Yeah. I was kidding. I don't know what high bloods or drone armies or anything are. I hate to be all, hi, I'm new here on your planet. Can you actually bring me, gradually bring me up to speed on literally everything? Watch in amazement as I stun you with my penetrating cluelessness. Feast your eyes on my barely executed jokes. Ha ha ha. You're pretty upbeat about all this. I think if I was suddenly shot across the galaxy or whatever, I'd be flipping out. Aren't you currently bleeding out under a ton of rocks? I guess so. It's kind of annoying to have no idea what's going on. Okay, well, the drones are the things flying around outside. They tuck us into custody if they see us, assuming they don't kill us outright by firing missiles into our bodies until we're dead. Oh. Yeah. Okay, well, a lot of this can wait until we get you to safety. I'm gonna go find your hover pad now. Talk to you soon. It looks like actually you weren't powering the door up with a power cell as you thought. From the override detected lockdown re-engage message, it seems like you were hacking it, sorta? Let's go with hacking. Oh hey, the tablet's doing the thing again. Oh, we have to do this again? Does this other one attack us? We have a player B going on here. This is harder. Oh, that's it? Hey, Xerox, you there? Can't really go anywhere else with the debris slowly crushing my body. Oof, right, sorry. It's okay. Try to move around a lot. I'll be there soon. Try to hang in there. Okay, I'll try. I'm gonna pass out a little now. Wait, real quick. I'm having trouble with this security puzzle, you could call it. I solved the one in the basement, no sweat, but this one seems kind of different. Security puzzle? I think it was doing okay. Do you mean the serpent from that Tetrarch Dammek rigged up to his power hexagrid? I wouldn't have used those words, but if you think that's what I'm talking about, it probably is. There's another one? A different one? I think so. The start screen is different anyway, and the power is still on, so I don't know what it would be connected to. His hive security, probably. He's always tinkering with it to make it more complex. Yeah, for the one in the basement, I only had to eat the letters. But now they're different? There's different letters to eat, but I don't know which letters to eat, if that makes sense. Oh, it's probably XXXXX. Oh, really? Wait, no, sorry, I meant XXX. Yeah, I got it. No, that's not it. What? I'm typing it in, but keeps getting changed just to a bunch of X's. Maybe it's that new security software installed? It must stop me from posting my password to the chat. Really? Let me try. Mrs. Taylor Thomas 80. Can you see that? Mrs. Taylor Thomas 80? OMG. What's that? No. You told me it would turn into X symbols. Well, you're using the Tetrox tablet. It wouldn't know your password. I can't believe I did that. Sorry, I'm going home. I can never show my face on this planet again. Huh? Mrs. Taylor Thomas 80 seems like a nice password. I'd never guess that. You must be really, really smart, Joey. No, apparently I'm super stupid. What's so embarrassing about it? Everybody makes mistakes. It's just, well, I guess it's the name of a boy I like. Really? Haha, don't tell anyone, but that's what my password is too. Oh? Do you have a girl you like? Oh no, it's a boy. Oh, for some reason I thought you were a boy all this time. I am, hehe. Oh. Huh. So I'm trying not to rush you or anything, but I'm still dying in rocks. About the security console? Yeah, about that. Can you, like, give me a hint? It's the name of our band, but there's a couple different ways to spell it. I forgot the name of the band. That's pretty weird. Yeah, we keep going back and forth between the XXXX and the XXX. I actually don't know which one it is right now. Well, I'll scout around and see if I can find something. He's bound to have written it down somewhere or something, right? I hope so. I'm gonna conserve my strength a little, but maybe getting kind of dead. A little bit, maybe. Kind of dead. Hang in there. I'll be there as soon as I can. Alright, we can't get back through there yet. Can't use anything on this. Okay, so we got another room there. Basically, there's two rooms to go off of here, I think.